Let's then go straight across to another of our special guests this evening. I'm joined by Pakistan's former President and Army Chief, General Pervez Musharraf. Appreciate your joining us, General Musharraf, here on India Today. Your first comments, General Musharraf, on Imran Khan's victory and the defeat of the Sharifs and the Bhutto Zardaris. Do you believe that this is a moment where Pakistan is finally moving away from the past to a new future, the Naya Pakistan that Imran talks about?
Yes, indeed. I think he's right. And you didn't point out one thing. The defeat of all religious extremists. That is very significant. All of them have been defeated here in these elections.
You say that the defeat of the religious extremists is significant, but there will be those who will say that's because the religious extremists have already been embraced and adopted, General Musharraf, by the mainstream parties. And Imran Khan and other leaders have already adopted and embraced the ideology of the religious extremists. Imran, for example, supports blasphemy laws. In the past, he supported the Loya Jirga. He was once called Taliban Khan. To that extent, the religious extremists, their space has been taken by the mainstream political parties.
No, that is not the case. He is not a religious extremist at all. And what I meant was, there was an MMA, all the religious parties joined together to form MMA, and there was a new group, which is a back group, which was supposed to be very powerful, but both of them got totally eliminated, almost defeated in detail, and that is the achievement of the people of Pakistan. It is not one man whose views, it is not Imran Khan's views alone, it is his party which has, whose views count. And they are all against religious extremism. And that has been proven in the elections here. Other than that, yes indeed, out of the three major parties, which is PTI, People's Party and PMLN, People's Party and PMLN have been tried and tested four times and they both failed Pakistan. So therefore, we are very happy that a new phase of Pakistan has come up. And inshallah, they will do well for the future. They will bring about change in Pakistan.
You seem to believe that Imran Khan will actually be able to bring about change. The feeling in India, General Musharraf, let me be very honest, is that Imran Khan is basically going to work under the dictates of the army. It's the army that's calling the shots. It's the army that prepared the pitch, certainly, for Imran in this election by eliminating Nawaz Sharif from the contest, by, in a sense, putting up some of these candidates who divided the anti-Nawaz, who helped divide the votes. Do you believe that Imran Khan is the candidate preferred choice of the army? It's the army that called the shots?
No, I think you're really insulting our judiciary and the army. The judiciary is independent and the army does not interfere. It is PTI with on its own force, they gained popularity, and we must give credit to them on that issue. Now the judiciary was totally impartial. Judiciary acted with justice, and on Panama leaks and many other issues, they punished the Nawaz Sharif was punished as he deserved. So I think let's not insult our judiciary. They did very well. The decisions were very appropriate.
But you've got Shahbaz Sharif, General Musharraf, the leader of the Pakistan Muslim League, Nawaz, who said the mandate of millions of people who came out to vote has been humiliated, our democratic process has been pushed back by decades. Bilawal Bhutto tweeted it was inexcusable and outrageous that his activists had been excluded across the country. If that is not rigging, then what else is? The entire opposition today is alleging that the elections were rigged to favor Imran Khan.
I mean, you are giving credence to people, you know, Bilawal saying something about his father. We know what his father is, what he has done, what kind of corrupt man he is. He is Mr. 90%. He's corrupted the whole, he's looted and plundered Pakistan. And we are giving him as the example. I don't want to take that as an example at all. Shahbaz Sharif, quoting about his brother. Brother has told lies in the assembly, he's told lies in the Supreme Court. He has forged documents and presented it in the Supreme Court. He has done money laundering of billions of rupees, if not dollars, and taken them to here, to Dubai and London, and we are quoting him. So what should I take about that? I think they have done something very wrong. They need to be punished, and punished harshly, which they have been. And that is very good.
So you believe
those who have good intentions for Pakistan, they want to govern well.
But General Musharraf, you believe Imran Khan is a change agent. Let's be honest. A change agent in the opposition, as we've seen in this country, it's easier to be a change agent in the opposition than once you're in power. Now Imran Khan will have to deliver. Your economy is in big trouble in Pakistan. The youth are demanding jobs. There is still sectarian violence in different parts of the country. The specter of terror remains a real threat to the stability of Pakistan. Do you accept that Imran Khan in power is going to find life much more difficult, especially on the economic and security front?
I mean, these are ups and downs of our country. Now, if you take my time, my period, we were on the upswing and we were doing very well. Our economy was doing very well. So these times change. Now it is, yes, indeed, we are not doing well at all. Then you are talking of sectarian hatred and sectarian conflict. What about the mass genocide against Muslims in India?
Come on, General Musharraf, I don't want to. General Musharraf, let's not allow this conversation on a day like this to seriously go on a downward spiral about your sectarianism versus genocide against Muslims. I think these are unfair words to use at a time like this. I don't want to make this an India-Pakistan battle. I'm asking you a serious question, that the Pakistani society faces the threat of terror and sectarianism like few others do. Do you believe Imran Khan can resolve these core issues?
Yes, indeed, we do face. We do face like you are facing. Why do you want to avoid when I tell the
Let's not use words like genocide. And today is a day to look at Pakistan in the light of your elections. That's why.
Let me come to what Imran Khan said today in his opening speech. He said, talking about India,
if they take one step towards us, we will take two. But at least we need a start. Where does India and Pakistan start now, given the fact that the two sides have such strong positions, especially on Kashmir? Do you believe that your four-point formula is where we must go back to again? Is that what you'd like to see?
I think so. There is no other formula. Nobody has presented any solution to Kashmir. So at least whatever I have said, that four-point formula is something which generally is acceptable. It is acceptable to the Kashmiris or your part of Kashmir, the Kashmiris of all our part, and all the general influential people. Everyone accepts this four-point formula as the formula for moving ahead. And that included your Prime Minister Vajpayee and Manmohan Singh. So yes, indeed, it's the best formula. Nobody else has presented any other thing.
Nobody has presented any other thing, but permit me to ask this. There will be a lot of skepticism, General Musharraf, in this country, because today we are talking, ironically, on what is celebrated as Vijay Divas in this country, General Musharraf, the Kargil misadventure which you are held responsible for. And the feeling in this country is, how do we trust Pakistan? General Musharraf and others have let us down repeatedly. Will Imran Khan also, for all his fine words, let us down? Please understand, there is a history, sir, a bloody history of mistrust. How do you overcome that mistrust?
Yeah, both sides should overcome it. If Siachen is not something that you did, and Kargil is the same, so why are you thinking that Kargil alone is a misadventure?
Because you were, I'm asking you, because we are today on the day of Vijay Divas, and you were the person, sir, who was seen to spearhead that operation that led to the debris of all the efforts that were made at the time to bring the two sides together in the spirit of the Lahore bus yatra that Atal Bihari Vajpayee had undertaken. So I'm just wondering today, if Imran Khan invites Prime Minister Narendra Modi, why should he go? Because we will fear that the next day there could be a bomb blast in Kashmir. So all the efforts go down in waste. So I'm just asking you this. Why should we be trusting a Pakistani leader at the moment when the sense in this country is the army calls the shots?
No. I think you are mistrusting Pakistan's side. I think it is we who do this. Here in Pakistan, the feeling is that it is you, at the present government at least. Modi's government is certainly not for peace with Pakistan. It is certainly with, they have a confrontationist attitude. They are offensive, they are belligerent against Pakistan, its army and the government. So therefore, please don't say that the Prime Minister Modi is a man of peace and he wants to move ahead on a peaceful path. That is not the case. It is he who has to go on a peaceful path. You don't clap with one hand.
Sir, Tali do haath se bachti hai. I accept that, but the fact is we got 26-11 after the efforts that we've made in the past. Our parliament was attacked. We've had Kargil. I'm sorry to go back into the past on a day like this, but that is why there is still skepticism about the country over Imran Khan taking over, leading to any real change. Because the more the things change, the more they remain the same when it comes to India, whoever comes to power in Pakistan, General Musharraf.
Dekhen, you are saying all this. Let me tell you, I personally know what you do in Baluchistan from Afghanistan. I personally know it. I personally know what Raw's involvement in Baluchistan and elsewhere even in KPK and frontier. I know it personally. So therefore, this...
Sir, you may know it personally. The world knows what happened in 2611. I had G. Parthasarathy, former High Commissioner, saying Imran Khan must make sure that the perpetrators of 2611 are prosecuted. Well, you need to win the trust of the Indian people. Yes, Imran Khan was a much-loved cricketer, but he's going to have to show now that he can actually deliver on issues that concern India. Would you concede that?
Yeah, not deliver, but appease, I would say. No, sir, we don't appease. And you don't threaten us that you have to do it, and then he'll do it. It depends on him. He is on a peace path. He wants to have peace with India. But don't challenge that. Don't challenge that the way you are doing. So I personally feel these things have happened, and you do the same. This Gulbashan Yadav, who's under arrest here in Pakistan, what was he doing? He has admitted that he's carried out so many terrorist attacks in Pakistan. You don't agree? You will never agree.
Let me though come back.
Whatever we do, whatever happens in your parliament, you are saying that it is from Pakistan.
Sir, there is enough proof now. Let's not go down what is now proven at various levels, the involvement of Pak-based terror groups. But I want to come back, though, to the issues of the time. Now, one of the issues which Imran Khan drove his campaign on was corruption. Nawaz Sharif eventually came back after he was prosecuted in the courts, convicted by courts. Will you come back? Are you going to come back to Pakistan? Nawaz Sharif says that you don't have the guts to come back to Pakistan and also face similar charges for alleged corruption.
I don't have to prove anything about myself. I don't have to prove my bravery or cowardice or whatever. People know me. The army knows me. And by the way, for your information, in 2013 I went back on my own volition.
Will you now go back again? Now that Imran Khan is the new Prime Minister of Pakistan, the Sharifs are not in power. Will you go back, General Saab, back to Pakistan?
I will. Yes, indeed, I will go back. When is the issue? A proper time has to be evaluated and I will go back.
But you know, when you say that, that only confirms what Imran Khan has always said. He says, you've got the Sharifs who've been caught in corruption, the Bhutto Zardaris who've been caught in corruption, and Musharraf also who faces serious charges. That's the reason the political vacuum that was created in Pakistan is what Imran Khan exploited. Now, that's, you know, leaders like you whom the people repose some faith, in your case, of course, through a military coup, people of Pakistan have lost faith in all of you. That's why they've chosen Imran Khan. Would you concede that today people have chosen Imran Khan because the likes of you let down the people of Pakistan?
Well, My popularity rating, sir, you should know, till March 2007, for 8 years, was at about 75-80%.
Then go back.
So please don't.
Then why don't you go back, sir?
And what I did not.
Then why don't you go back to Pakistan?
Yes, I will go back. I will know that there are other reasons, because my going back would have distracted from the whatever was happening, elections coming up and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore I decided not to go. I'll go at the right moment. I don't have to go in a person and show my personal bravado. This is not an issue of personal bravado. It's an issue of a country, or my country, or my people, and their welfare.
Let me come back to the relationship.
I will go.
Let me come back, General Saab.
I will go.
Let me come back to the relationship between the civilian leadership and the army, because Pakistani Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa on Wednesday urged the people to vote to defeat the inimical forces working against the country. A day later, Imran Khan gets elected. There's a belief that the army, as I come back to it, sided with Sharif and sided with Imran Khan against the Sharifs and the Bhutto Zardaris. What was the role that the army played in this election, according to you? Was it really a neutral umpire, yes or no?
No. Yes, neutral umpire. It was the role of a neutral umpire, and whatever the army chief said was what we desire, what the whole of Pakistan, every Pakistani desires that. And he said that. Now otherwise, and as far as Imran Khan and PTI are concerned, they won on their own strength, which they developed, which is very good. Had there been any role of the army, they would have made sure that even in Punjab also PTI wins, which is not the case. So therefore, let's not doubt unnecessarily that the army sort of got things rigged.
Let me ask you therefore a final question. Do you believe that the hatred against India will end simply because of government changes in Pakistan? During the campaign, there was a lot of anti-India. Do you believe now that there's a change in power and we have a government, will the rhetoric finally end? Will anyone in Pakistan now be willing to reach out to India?
Sir, your problem is that you always think that there is rhetoric from this side against India. That is not the case. It is always by you, by your politicians, by your military men, by your leaders who spit venom against Pakistan. Not Pakistanis. Pakistanis don't do
it. Sir, you had a Hafiz Saeed. You had a country where a Hafiz Saeed, sorry to say this, actually contested the elections. I know he won no seats, but his rhetoric was entirely against India. Imran Khan also suggested that the Sharifs are hand in glove with India. It all seemed as if anyone during that election campaign who wanted to win hearts struck out against India.
No, that doesn't happen. And Hafiz Saeed is a person, he's got a good following, he has a large following. Therefore, he says whatever he said.
He's also a terrorist who is the main accused in the 2611.
But otherwise, they don't. No, sir. No. He's not a terrorist. That is what you think. We think he's a mujahid. Let's not get into the discussion.
Okay. I will therefore ask you today.
You take him to be a terrorist, we don't take him to be a terrorist.
I will ask you today, do you believe that Pakistan, are you hopeful of the new Pakistan, this Naya Pakistan that Imran Khan talks about? Are you hopeful of it? Do you believe there will be a new Pakistan?
I think so, because he has the sincerity and he has the will. He is, in Urdu as they say, niyat achhi honi chahiye. His niyat is good, he wants to do. He wants to serve the people. He wants to carry out welfare of the people, do good to the people. Yeah, I think he'll achieve it.
Okay, we'll wait and see whether the niyat scores over what has happened in the past in your country. But we wish you well. I believe a stable Pakistan is in the interests of the subcontinent, and I pray that the futures of this subcontinent, government spend less, sir, on guns, and spend more on education and health. And I hope that one day we can see permanent peace between India and Pakistan, as they would say in your part of the world, General, Insha'Allah. Thank you very much.
You keep spending.
Well, we keep hoping. We keep living in hope.
Yet you keep spending on weapons.
Well, that's true, but we keep hoping.
What are you spending?
And you keep sending terrorists across the border. So I don't want to get into this tutu meme, General. I don't want to say that you keep sending terrorists, we keep spending on security. And you will tell me about Baluchistan, it's a zero-sum game. At the moment, I think let's hope, as I said, that Pakistan gets the peace and stability it deserves. Thank you very much, General Musharraf, for joining me here on this India Today special.
I hope you...
Thank you. I wish you well.
I only hope you mean every word of what you're saying.
I do, but I remain a well-wisher of a peaceful subcontinent. Thanks very much for joining me.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you would love to.